Welcome to the first of our three-part series in Mondulkiri Province. In this episode, we find what must be one of the best camps in Cambodia, once again find ourselves in the middle of another monsoonal thunderstorm.
She's coming down now.
And explore one of the most beautiful and empty waterfalls in the country.
Look at that!
Welcome to another episode of Adventure Unlimited. We are currently driving through Tebong Khmum province. We're heading east. We're going to go through Krathi province, and then our destination for this trip is Mondulkiri. We're doing this trip in September, which statistically speaking is the absolute worst time of year to do it. But we've only got 2 years here, and the weather's really nice for about 4 months of the year, so we don't have time to wait for it to be perfect. So the only thing we've really got set in stone for this week is in 2 days we're going to go and meet up with the Mondulkiri Project, which is a non-government organisation that rescues elephants from the wild, and they're also really actively involved in preserving biodiversity, preventing illegal logging, which there is quite a lot of in Mondulkiri. Yeah, it looks awesome. We're super excited about this week. Not sure if you can really tell from the videos that we've done previously or not, but we haven't actually had a whole lot of time to go exploring in Cambodia. It's usually been like 2, 3, maybe 4 nights. So to have a full week to be able to get right out to one of the most remote provinces and have a look around. Super stoked, cannot wait.
Filmed any of the setup because there's a storm coming, but I swear to God, if we get wet this time like we did in Koh Rong, I'm gonna be so sad. So it's a bit of a race against the clock, and then settle in,
try and
stay dry, get a fire going.
Get the bed set up and then get a fire going.
And we'll be set. We'll be set to enjoy the storm.
so it's getting pretty dark now, but
pretty well set up. The wind is coming from the other side of the car, so Paul reckons no awning wall. TBC whether that's a bad decision, because she's about to come down any minute now. It's pretty cool, we've got like the clouds popping up like right next to our camp. Paul's hard at work.
A better system than last time.
Our bed stays right.
But it's just like that. It stops.
Beautiful, yeah.
Yeah, it's nice. After complaining all afternoon that he was hot.
I am not hot.
What are you now?
Cold. No, actually nice.
Ah, joys of it. Wet season camping. Very civilized dinner tonight. After getting all the cooking stuff out and setting it up so we didn't have to grab it in the rain.
That's right. Beers, hummus,
fire, lightning. The lightning will come the second I hit stop. It's been pretty consistent. Oh, there we go.
She's coming down now. I'm dressed very sensibly.
Don't
want. You put your shirt back on.
Yeah. T-shirt, shorts. My slides.
Even brought my ski pants. And you might think, why did you bring ski pants to Cambodia? Well, we thought at some stage we might go to Japan.
We will.
Oh, but it's like Bali now.
Yeah, I'll go to Bali. Half the place is worth it. It's been too long.
Yeah. Anyway, they're paying off because they're kind of waterproof. And it's kind of chilly.
It's not chilly. It's beautiful. I've been praying for this for the last 6 months.
Anyway, we'll check in the morning. And hopefully it doesn't rain all night. But if it does, it's all good. Good morning.
Morning. Beautiful night out here.
Oh my goodness, so peaceful. With the exception of the chainsawing, which went well into the night. And just literally up in the clouds this morning. It's unreal.
So we're about 2.5 k's from the Vietnam border, and the border is a river. So I think, like, down where you can see that cloud in that valley, I reckon that's where the river is. So that peak just there is Vietnam. It's pretty cool.
We did have some encounters with the local wildlife, mainly the ants this morning. They're into everything. We left our food box out. Everything's pretty much sealed, but thousands of ants in it.
We didn't learn from last time.
We'll never learn.
It was buckling down when we went to bed, so we didn't want to run out in the rain and put it in the car.
Yeah.
But I'll be right.
Yeah. And then I had my rain jacket hanging up on the quick shade supports overnight to dry out a bit. And it turns out ants quite like that too. The inner lining's black, so I couldn't really see them, so I just put my rain jacket on this morning because it was a bit cool. And then I could, like, feel some ants. I shook it off, and Paul's like, take your T-shirt off now!
There was hundreds. There was green, and there was more black on the T-shirt than there was green. I ripped that off, and they're just everywhere. I could not believe how many were on her.
So anyway, it turns out the ants like the rain jacket. I don't blame them. It's a nice rain jacket. Anyway, we're just going to enjoy our coffee. In no rush to pack up this morning because we've only got to go about 25 k's up the road. And I think we might backtrack a little bit back on Route 76. And there's a waterfall not too far back, and a little community eco-tourism centre. So I think that might be our main thing that we do today. There is more rain forecast, so let's play it by ear. Up the road once you get to the back to the main road. This little waterfall. It's even got signs. We're not driving through here. It's a walking track.
So first stop of the day, we are at a waterfall called
Lang something. I'll put the name down the bottom. Looks like about a 300 meter walk in. I was expecting, because it's on Google as like a community, like eco-tourist center, so I was expecting to have to pay some money to someone, but there's no one here. Is it Tuesday, so maybe they just met on weekends?
Yeah. Ah, the serenity inside the jungle. Buds are so loud. Obviously, we're the first ones down today because there's Plenty of cobwebs.
Oh, that is rough.
Bit hard to tell. Go straight down. I'm glad there's concrete steps here.
Oh, drop it. Oh, we can get there.
Crocs on. Hiking mode activated. Very graceful. Let's go, go. Let's go, let's go. Look at that! Rocky terrain. Doesn't look like it's very popular, which is awesome.
Yeah.
So now we've got the hike back up. These bloody stairs.
We spent the remainder of the day exploring some tracks and sites around the southwest approaches to Sen Monorom.
Just hanging out here with my dad. Chilling out. He's a bit of a monkey.
Before checking into our guest house in Sen Monorom in preparation for our tour with the Mondulkiri project the following day. Make sure you tune in to the next episode when we jump in the back of a ute and drive deep into the jungle, getting up close to elephants in their natural habitat and eat, drink, sleep, hike, and enjoy the spoils of nature with the Bunong tribal minority in Mondulkiri. He thinks I'm weird because I'm happy.
There's not many women in the world that would drive out to the top of a random mountain in Cambodia in a clapped out old 80 series and in a wet season and just set up here and just sit in the pissing rain and be happy.
Just trying to
handle up there.
Film how nice the morning is, and everything is covered in ants.